Welcome back to the Chainsaw Bar. I'm Mike Taylor, joined as always with
Clayton Arch,
Hillbilly Jane,
Delano,
and Delano. Welcome back. This episode, we're going to be talking about a bunch of random questions about Halloween since it's that season. And let's get started with some quick questions just to get everybody's mind firing. Favorite Halloween candy? Clayton.
Oh, man. I enjoy the popcorn balls, man. Those are exclusive to Halloween. I can't wait. Yeah,
you like to put them in his mouth.
Yeah, I'll put some salty sweet balls with popcorn in my mouth.
Those are a classic.
Me, Starburst.
I like Starburst. Oh, yeah, good taffy. Delicious.
The best.
Yeah, you like when stars burst in your mouth.
Right? Like them balls that burst in your mouth.
Gene is the biggest star fucker we know.
Oh, God.
Damn.
Holy cats. Delano, what you got?
For circus peanuts.
Circus peanuts. Those, Where the fuck do you even get those?
I keep thinking they come in solid. He just wants a big old nut. Circus peanuts.
Circus peanuts.
The peanuts. Yeah, the little orange.
Oh, yeah.
The circus peanuts. There's a picture.
Okay, so usually people don't like those.
No, they look great.
They're okay. Yeah, I like them.
Yeah. Not for
me. And what did I say? I'm just drawing a blank. You fucking penises.
Fucking ass.
Oh, yeah.
He's
yeah,
thinking about penises.
As soon as the penis hits, my brain goes flat and I just go glassy eyed. Jaw drops. It's awful.
Yeah.
Screw you guys.
Pretty bad.
Oh, yeah.
I'm getting up. I'm going to the cooler right now.
There's no cooler. You're not getting no damn cooler.
You just talk about penises.
Anyway, sit your ass down. We got candy corn. Is probably it, yeah. Halloween time, candy corn. For me, that's it. It's like I get packs of candy corn, I'll be happy.
Yeah.
If I get Tootsie Rolls, I'll be just as happy, but not quite as Halloween.
Is there flavors of candy corn? Or
they started doing that like 5 or 7 years ago. There's like berry flavored, and it's like, not a fan.
It's just sugared wax, man.
It's sugar wax, and it tastes like honey. There's a hint of honeyness to it.
Yeah. But damn it, man, if you didn't have it, it would be Halloween.
That's true.
That's true. Yeah, you know as soon as you see that, it's the fall time.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, we're going to pop to the Joker question. Horror movie? Some of us have seen it, some of us haven't. I'm on the solid side of feeling that's a horror movie. It's just terrible. It's just like, that feels like a horror film. It's just like, at no point was I not feeling like something foreboding was happening and there was like just a gut terror kind of.
That's fair enough. I mean, was it horrible in a psychological way, or was it just
the way he was?
It was a psychological.
Yeah.
It was kind of like American Psycho, how that's a horror movie.
So he's like slowly unraveling, and
yeah, just stuff you just don't know what's going on until like you're like, and then even after it's over, you're sitting there confused.
Oh, okay,
it's impressive. It's a fantastic. If he doesn't get an Oscar for it, then well. Somebody better be impressive, because that was an impressive portrayal of
Oscars. Are going to Robert Downey Jr.
For
yeah,
what?
That's
he died as Iron Man, damn it.
Come on, man.
I don't care what Scorsese says.
Tony Stark is the life of a Marvel. Right.
Okay. Marvel movies are cinematic in their own right.
And he's the death of the cinematic universe.
So. Yeah, his death will definitely put an M nail in that coffin for the MCU. But
Tom Holland's the golden boy.
Isn't that owned by Sony? Isn't Sony doing that?
They're supposed to be buying it. Disney's supposed to be actually buying.
Well, with that being said, when they said that Spider-Man was going back to Sony, I'm pretty sure that they had a meeting and Disney was just like, you know, we didn't buy you. Mm-hmm. And so I'm pretty sure they changed their tune.
What do you think about the Joker?
The Joker is awesome. I'm telling you what, back in the 90s, the first one, when Jack Nicholson done it.
Yeah, not even the guy from
Everybody else. I got the fucking original one. I ain't talking about the 50s. I'm talking about Jack Nicholson. He was the greatest of the great.
He set the bar, I will agree.
Yeah, the rhubarb.
Because when you think of that type of character, that type of character portrayal, it's always going to be that kind of style from him on.
Yeah. What about Mark Hamill?
I love Mark Hamill's Joker.
Mark Hamill's Joker is just drawn, but it's just his voice. It's,
yeah, I mean, but he's great.
But that's a part of it.
His, yeah, that's part okay, of it. But
okay. Listen, don't be messing with another man's rhubarb.
That's a good line. It's true. But Mark Hamill, you don't even know exists. He doesn't know who Mark Hamill is.
Oh, yeah, he doesn't know
Mark
Hamill.
So he's got, it doesn't even rank. So.
I got him.
Yeah, that is old school. What are you talking about?
It's a different thing he didn't touch. So it's like, eh. Some people don't go with it.
It's like I would like to see a live action with Mark Hamill's voiceover.
So it's like, know. It's like you're, you
that'd be pretty cool.
That would be kind of weird.
It's like you were the Star Wars over here and he's all about fucking John Wayne or something.
It seems reasonable, yeah.
True grit motherfucker.
The Fistful of Dollars person.
Yeah. Type, yeah, he's definitely that style. Okay. Yeah, it is what we are. All right, let's pop into a little segment I like to call, What Did We Learn This Week? Just randomly, did you learn anything this week? This is just going to be off the wall.
It's an educational podcast now.
This is educational.
I learned that, you know, getting ready to do podcasts or keeping things in order is pretty damn rough. It's hard to do. Keep up the scheduling and keep going. Yeah, it's just you never know how to keep going. Like, you never know who's going to be there. You never know if you're going to do it. You never know. Just keeping the shows going is just the hardest thing ever.
Yeah, keeping everybody wrangling is, definitely agree. It's like, just to get everything popped up today is like, wing ding. We're trying to gun this.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
What'd you learn, Jim?
You learn anything this week, Gene?
Well, let's see. What in the hell did I learn? I got me new fishing pole. So that kicked ass. It's a dollar. Awesome.
That's a good brand.
Huh?
So.
That was a good brand. That's what Gene learned. That's a good fishing pole. I agree. I think I have one.
And bought some cool fishing lures. The Rebel. Caught some fish, top water. This time of year. Awesome as shit, man.
Awesome.
You learned that you were a walleye.
No, I ain't got one of those, but I am a walleye.
What you got?
I'm getting walleye right now.
What you got, first Blaine? What you learned this week? You're a big brain kind of dude. You deal with all sorts of shit.
Oh, God. I learned that it's 87 kilometers between Cherokee and Snowbird.
That is insane.
Yeah.
What's that in American?
Yeah, like miles.
Hell if I know.
Like miles, motherfucker.
I don't know. You got a smartphone on your damn thing. So.
He does not have a smartphone. He's got a flip phone. 87 kilometers?
Well, there's that bleep.
That's horrifying. It sounds like a lot.
It's pretty good distance.
Did you run that or did you drive it?
No. We're bringing fiber to the home on the reservation. So everybody's going to have a fiber optic internet connection.
Lucky bastards.
And part of doing that, we're having to set up these things called DWs.
It's like, and 54 miles.
Yeah. And that's in a straight line.
Yeah. It's a lot of money. Sounds like a lot of money.
All the fiber optic cable we're going to have to pull to get this situated is a lot. But, you know, the chief is going through with his promise, and we're actually going to get decent internet. Soon.
Shocking. That's cool. At least that he's going to go through that.
Can't, yeah, that's that. The only horror story in Cherokee is the chief.
Right, lately. But
yeah.
At least now it's like not a horror story. At least he's going to bring... Yeah, the internet prior to this has been a horror story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go with that.
Awful.
The worst thing is going to be Snowbird because it's so far away and Rough Ranch.
Maybe we can... Yeah.
Rough Ranch is...
Because we don't have a node, like the closest node out that way is the Wolftown community building.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's on top of the mountain. I learned again. I still hate people, and they are just so crass. It's unbelievable. Yeah, you can hear our opinions all damn day, but you don't need our personal lives much.
You sons of
bitches. You dirty. You're listening to us. All right, let's get to the segment that we may have lost and didn't get. What movie do you watch every fall? Every fall, every Halloween season, what movie do you watch? Gene, let's pop with you real quick. You might be on fire right now. Hit it.
Probably The Last Man on the Earth.
Yeah.
The Vincent Price one. That's a classic. Yeah.
With Vincent Price.
Is that in color or is that black and white?
Black and white.
Isn't that like the...
He says, oh, well, I'm guessing we'll have to refresh my garlic today.
Isn't...
I'm going to have to go to the store and want to refresh the garlic.
Isn't that movie a ripoff of I Am Legend?
Hell, I don't know. It came out anyway.
What you got for us?
I think I Am Legend's like a remake.
It's post-apocalyptic.
Yeah, but Last Man on Earth, that's mine.
A great fall movie.
Oh, hell yeah, man. Most definitely.
Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
What?
That's a modern one, but yeah.
It's a modern one, but it's just so hilarious. Like,
what is it?
Tucker and Dale
versus Evil.
Yeah, I love that film.
It's God, kid, we got your friend.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what, like 7 or 8 years old now? Maybe 10.
Came out in 2011, I think. 2012.
It's been out there a while now.
It's been out for a good while.
That's good. But yeah, that's a modern choice.
It's a good one. It's like a spoof on horror. And
dude, we're going to have to
kind of scary at times.
We're going to have to do a thing on that one. And The Last Man on Earth.
We'll definitely cover those subjects in the future, definitely.
Because
those
that
are
one.
We'll definitely do a Vincent Price section.
Seen that? Oh, 2010.
Oh, you're gonna love that film. I'll have to lend it to you later.
A bunch of wall eyes like you, Chad.
just to be cool, like just be happy.
See, if you was ever in a horror movie, Gene, then it'd be Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
I got you, brother. It's solid.
Going with me, I'm just going with a classic. Like, as soon as it gets cold and fall-y, feeling I put on The Crow, hardly ever do I miss that. It's like,
is The Crow horror, though? Like, is it like, it's like...
There's like the whole supernatural, anything supernatural to me can be in the horror sound.
He's kind of a ghost.
He's kind of like an undead spirit of vengeance.
He's not really dead, he's undead.
Yeah, and I always like the fact that he's just out there just to kill.
Yeah.
It's just like... Kill. And then he died in the film, so there's that.
No one in his family lives to see a sequel.
Yeah, that's a dark
damn heritage.
I don't know about that. I mean, that's a good one. Yeah, I like that one. I'm jealous.
Anytime it gets cold and dark and rainy, fall time, that comes on. It's just like, tick. It's like, man, I need to watch Crow.
Fuck.
Love that one.
That's really
cool. I think I need a cigarette.
Oh, you know, we're doing a show right now. I mean,
you had a cigarette before we started. Anyway, next, what you got?
I don't know, man.
I mean, this is so hot. I mean, I need a cigarette, you know what I mean?
It's hot.
It's cigarette burns. No, I don't know, man. Whenever it comes around, I don't mind watching any horror movie at all, but I like to watch a good zombie flick, and I usually like to watch the good zombie flick I like is Land of the Dead, usually around Halloween, because it's kind of like cold looking, fallsy looking. You know, zombies start becoming intelligent, start trying to take over the city again. Like they take down the bad guys and they kind of isolate themselves from the zombies, but they don't want to be left out. But they start adapting,
Is that the one where he's got the gas station clerk?
Yeah, he's like a gas station attendant, and
he owns a gas station though.
Well, I mean, he keeps trying
to do his job.
Yeah, he keeps trying to pump gas, and then eventually, like, they come out, and then he's smart, and then he's teaching the rest of them to be smarter, and then it's regaining his humanity, sort of. And there's an interesting thing about that movie is like it's like you got John Leguizamo and Dennis Hopper in it. It's like because they went head to head again, like they did in Super Mario Brothers.
Oh my god!
If you remember Super Mario Brothers, they get to go head to head again. He gets to take on the bad guy. But
that's amazing. You spun that. That's disgusting.
It's pretty great. Like,
I can't believe that.
Well, see, like up until a couple years ago, I didn't even realize that. It's like they were totally in Mario Brothers together. And it's
yeah, that's true.
But, I mean,
best video game ever.
So that's a movie we actually need to watch 1 week and.
Is it Mario Bros?
Well, that one maybe. It's a horror movie of itself.
We could watch the pair up together. It's like, this is an epic battle. We need to see both ends.
So it's like Mario Brothers was the first movie And then, like, Land of the Dead is the second movie, when Luigi and fucking King Koopa are in the zombie apocalypse.
That's funny.
That's
kind of the same thing. It really is.
So Land of the Dead, yeah, that's a great film.
Yeah, Land of the Dead, definitely watch that one, man. I did.
Love it. All right, what we look forward to this week is, like, it's been a not an amazing movie week. Like, there's been some good stuff. The Joker came out, like, a few weeks ago, but a lot of people are on the fence about that being a horror film.
Zombieland Double Tap.
Zombieland Double Tap did come out on that. I haven't got to see it.
So you gotta go see it. It's good.
It's not bad.
He's giving us a second episode review and gotta see it, but... not playing in Silva, so...
Three from Hell came out this week.
Did you get the T-shirt?
Last week, I mean, sorry.
Did you go buy the T-shirt? Did you go buy the Walmart version?
I was still trying to scavenge for the Walmart version. I mean, I'd already had my copy, but I still want the Disco Sucks. If y'all know where you could buy or have one that you want to sell, I want the Disco Sucks T-shirt. Yeah. I want to be the Midnight Wolfman.
Such a good one.
Yeah, dude. Have you watched it yet? No, you're the Midnight Werebear. Get out of here. Have you watched Three from Hell yet?
No. I won't do that. I'm there.
All right, that's the next movie we're watching.
100%.
So maybe next week we'll do Three from Hell.
Next week we'll do Three from Hell so Gene can get it off his list.
That's...
And you go home and you watch Devil's Rejects and House of a Thousand... Oh, fuck.
Damn, that's a werebear.
That is a werebear.
Whoa. Anyway. See when I see
you. Well, there's some good stuff coming out though. There's the Doctor Sleep's coming out next month on the 8th.
Yeah, I'm kind of looking forward to that.
So
I don't know how they're going to do that because of certain things that happened in The Shining.
Yeah, it's Hollywood
what
magic.
What kind of certain things?
What, have you seen The Shining?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know if everyone here has seen it.
But I mean, what do you mean? How are they gonna do it? Like, what are you?
Like, all right. So when Jack kills, what was the black dude's name?
Dick Halloran, whatever.
Yeah, Halloran. But when he was listed in the thing on the cast records in the sequel, and I'm like, he got hit in the chest with an axe.
Well, he's talking.
What the hell?
He has The Shining, so that's what he does. No. What I'm saying is he had The Shining, but also Danny had The Shining, which allows him to see the dead. So it might just be, he just might be talking with Dick's ghost.
But
like, he might just be interacting with his ghost because he's interacting with the paranormal.
That's true.
Like, he's interacting with paranormal because he's writing on the wall messages to the other side. And then maybe he came out to visit him, and that's what he's doing. He's having a chat with him.
Yeah. True. That is true. It's like he is talking to the dead. It's kind of like the Sixth Sense and all that jazz, but...
You got to think logically here, man. I mean...
Howlran.
Why wasn't he able to see... Like, he was able to see all the ghosts in the hotel. So that's what it enables him to do. So he's able to
Didn't the mom start seeing them too?
No, she just seemed like
just seemed the craziness.
Crazy husband just losing it and just badness.
Like, this was the thing, it's like only the husband and the son really seen anything most of the time.
Yeah, that's his genetics are damn throwing that up probably.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that is a good looking film.
Wouldn't it be cool if they brought back Jack Nicholson for a cameo in that? Like, he talks to him. Like, talks to his dad before he's
some
crazy.
Sort of weird dark man. Conversation, that would be like something.
You know, so, I mean, that would be cool. I'm looking forward to that. That's what I'm asking
for. Just for that potential?
Yeah.
I haven't read the book. I know Big Joe at work, he read it, said it's amazing.
I need to read the book, too.
Yeah, he's like, you need to go read that book. I'm like, damn it. This was like a year ago. They're making a movie of it. You need to read it.
I feel like if I read the book before I watch the movie, I might have too high expectations.
True.
So I might watch the movie first and then try to read the book. See where they differ.
Ugh. Be like Moss and the IT Crowd. I've got the children's version and the adult version to see if they edit anything and just have to sit there and flip through and compare. Just terrible. That's the road you're going down.
We'll get to that one. That was good.
You looking forward to anything this week, Gene?
Not really. I mean, I got a few movies, old movies, like some 70 movies that I was going to watch. I forget their names or whatnot. But yeah, I mean, I watch a film every day.
Yeah.
I mean, I watch a horror film every day after work and whatnot. I might watch half of one and whatnot like that, but I'm always into that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's why I keep you on here. Damn right. That's why I started this stupid podcast, just so I can pick your brains for that shit. That's
great. Well, I tell you one good, one old one, scare the, well, when you go, might not scare the hell out of you. Watch Sister, Sister. Look it up if you can.
You talk about that one with those, Tamara?
No. Oh, yeah.
Sister, Sister?
I said, what? I said, freaking,
the tween show?
No, I was talking about that's, him.
Listen, that's more scary than, by God, what I'm talking about.
Yeah. I was thinking of the Whoopi Goldberg fucking singing movie when he told me that the other day, and I was like, "What? The Whoopi Goldberg thing?"
Wait, oh wait. Speaking of Whoopi Goldberg,
that was a good horror film.
Wait. Here's what I'm
not to ball that from you.
I'm going to interrupt you and right. Add on to my look forward to.
And lock my cigarette. Hey.
Whoopi Goldberg got cast in the Stand, the upcoming remake of The Stand.
Ew.
So she's going to be Mother Abigail.
News to everybody, that's brand new. Wow.
And she's going to be going up against Bill Skarsgård, who played Pennywise in the new It series. He's going against his brother, who is playing... I apologize, I don't know his name, but he's going to be playing Randall Flagg. So his brother's going to be playing Randall Flagg against her mother, Abigail, in the new Stand. Stand. So that's what I'm looking forward to. I don't know when it's coming out, but definitely... Well, definitely can't wait.
Whoopi Goldberg, I got to say this, she's a talented person, and I am looking forward to that if she's in a horror film, because she's done a great job.
Especially Stephen King.
Oh, is it Stephen King?
Stand,
yeah. Oh, man. Hey, man.
Post-apocalyptic.
Yeah.
Because she's good act.
Yeah.
That's straight up.
Yeah, she's good.
Because in like The Color Purple, that was a great movie.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Yeah, great can't woman. Hate that. Yeah, she's done some great stuff in her career.
Oh, God, my.
Just fun to watch. Just fun to listen to.
Yeah. Yep. She's a good act.
Yeah. All right, Delano, what you looking forward to this week?
None.
Nothing at all?
Delano, we're going to have to put you on since you're Italian, you know?
Yes.
Italian. Oh, yeah. Gina Bernelli.
Gino Bernelli.
That was, yeah.
Oh, God.
Bernelli. Not the gun, but Bernelli.
Bernelli.
That's his last name. Anyway,
Bernelli. Is this your top 10?
Yeah. Shining.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That was like first episode. But that, I had to find that last name.
Gino Bernelli, and this is Gino. Delano.
Gino Bernelli.
So good.
Delano DeLeon.
Yep. All right, so I'm looking forward this week. I'm looking forward to Double Tap. That's got to be seen.
Does.
Yep. So that's gonna be fun times. I got to probably travel to see it unless it comes out Thursday.
See, by next week you need to have seen.
Yeah, by next week I will have seen it.
Give me a beer.
Well, by next week you can't have any beer before the show.
Definitely not next week. Yeah, you can chug all you want.
Chug all you want. Yeah.
All right, moving ahead. We're gonna talk quickly about Train to Busan. That was today's movie. We're doing a movie review. We've all seen it now.
Yeah.
And
Delano,
what do you think?
Like your own show.
Italians only.
It was, I mean, it's your standard South Korean flick. It was pretty depressing.
South Koreans can be. But they can be so poppy, though. Like, Psy?
Yeah,
come
it was
on.
Pretty. It was I pretty, mean, pretty upbeat.
What, the movie that we watched, man, it was a great movie.
Why was it a great movie?
The reason that it wasn't a great movie, I mean, you had to read the movie. I mean, it had subtitles.
He doesn't like subtitles, so yeah.
Subtitles suck, and everybody hates them. But if you like horror films and stuff like that...
So he likes the dub anime.
The damn thing
is... Doesn't even watch anime.
No.
I'm just saying, he likes the dub.
Yeah.
The thing of it is, if you like horror films and you like the picture, you're going to read it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It don't matter what they speak.
I agree with you, because if you're sitting there reading subtitles, you might miss something. Like, you might miss a key element unless you know what, if you've seen it already.
Me,
True.
I ain't like Yens. I ain't like you guys. When I watch a subtitle movie, okay, I'm sitting there pausing it, and I'm like analyzing it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're gonna step by step it.
Yeah, I'll make sure that I know what the movie's about step by step.
Yeah.
All the way. I know that sounds horrible. I mean, you can ask my girlfriend. She'll tell you straight up, you cannot watch a movie with me because I'm pausing it all the time.
Oh, I mean, that's why we don't give you the remote.
Exactly. Yeah. That's why our choice in subtitles will be really well watched.
I'm going to play it back. You know what I'm saying? Even if it's in English, I got to pause it, got to play it back, and I got to analyze it. Is this what happened?
Yeah. Yeah. All right. What did you take from Train to Busan this afternoon?
Yeah, man. What was your favorite thing about it?
What popped with you?
You know, you hated the subtitle reading.
That was the part you hated, but what did you like?
What did I like?
Yeah.
The scare factor. That, you know, it was an everyday life, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Everyday life. And, it could happen to anybody, you know? And that when it comes to zombie films and stuff like that, now they took a little, what was funny is they, and I ain't even going to tell you into this, but they took a lot from American zombie films, and I'm just going to let you watch the film, and then you watch for yourself and see.
Everything's dick riding Romero, so yeah, it's just the way it works.
Romero started it.
Everything's gonna be Romero'd of some fashion.
It's funny. It's not really scary, but it's a great film.
All right, that's an opinion. All right, go get your cigarette, and we're just gonna keep talking.
Get my throat cancer here.
Other way.
Not the front door. Front door.
There. Dicks.
That way. We'll get him there.
We'll get him in that cigarette sucking. We'll get him sucking on something. All right, what did you have to say about the Train to Busan?
Oh, man. What is there to say about it that, you know, at least he didn't say already? It's just a good flick, man. Just a different take on where zombies can hit.
Mm-hmm, true.
Like, I wouldn't want that to happen. I mean, I don't like closed-in places anyway. I'm kind of claustrophobic. So, having to deal with an army of zombies, like an outbreak of zombies inside of a train, how narrow trains are, that sucks, man. I have the only chance to hide in those narrow bathrooms or, you know, stuff like that. It's pretty messed up. I thought the movie was great. Like, I agree, having read subtitles kind of takes away from it. But
yeah,
in the end, I thought the story was good. Very fucking depressing, and it has heart. Like, the movie definitely has a lot of heart, and it makes you want to tear up. It makes me want to tear up when I watch it, man. It's a good ending. So if y'all haven't seen that movie, definitely check it out, because it is a fucking beast of a movie.
Yeah, that's a good damn film. The subtitles, I have no problem with subtitles. I don't even hear the people, so that's kind of like, once I start reading subtitles, I don't hear the voices, so I couldn't tell you any of the characters' voice styles or anything. I can tell you anything but their voices or anything. But once I start reading, it's just like, I'll read and I'll just look at, like, it may as well have no sound hardly. Mm-hmm. But that's my takeaway from the subtitles.
They also did have, like, the really good villain guys in there, as in addition to the zombies. Like, the villains are just class acts, too.
They made you hate them.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, people don't take that away. They were like, all right, that guy sucked. But then it's like, man, that guy was great.
Yeah.
As a villain.
Yeah.
Because it's like, it's easy to play the good guy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, it's trickier to play the bad guy.
It's like, you have to be a good bad guy if you make the audience just loathe you, you know, like at, by the end of the movie, you just like, you've done a good job.
Yeah, if you're cheering just like, his demise or something, his win.
Yeah. Like, this motherfucker, like if everybody's like, this motherfucker at the end of the movie, that's a good feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, they definitely had that in there.
Yeah, do you love that? Yeah, there was a couple one. I love how the government just covered it up again. They were like, oh, there's... It's something, but it's not quite anything to worry about. The government's covering it. Mm-hmm. And I like that cover angle. It was kind of just like...
And then we'll start ranking movies. Here's how our ranks go. It's like 1 to 10. Like 1 being the absolute worst. Like we call 1... You give it a Wadzilla. 1's the Wadzilla. And then the 10 is groovy.
I don't know. There's got to be something worse than Wadzilla. Wadzilla I can watch. There's some stuff I cannot watch.
What's like? What can we give it? Like
a 1. Yeah, for you, Wadzilla would be a 1. For me, like sitting through. Wadzilla's a 10. Wadzilla's in the solid 6-7 area. Yeah. Solid. Like, I don't know. Like a horrible, bad like horror movie would be.
Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
No. I haven't seen that in years, and I'm not planning to again, but it's okay. Yeah. It'd be like, no, if we were doing on the, if we could do like the Chainsaw Massacre, like, it'd be like the new blood. That'd be a 1.
Next Generation?
That'd be like the McConaughey like episode.
Dude, that one was good, though. I mean, I don't know. I thought it was definitely a different take, but it was good.
Yeah. No, I can't, like horror movies, just bad horror movies. It's hard to find.
A lot of them are just really, really bad. That's like why I could say Wadzilla being like.
We looked it up. I had to look it up. The movie that we started watching was called The Creeps.
The Creeps.
And there's this.
Not Night of the Creeps.
Not the Night of the Creeps, which is like a solid 9, 10. Yeah. Like The Creeps, which is a solid probably 1.
Oh, okay.
That's the one where like the mad. Like college professor guy steals Mary Shelley's Frankenstein book because apparently that had the recipe to create monsters in it.
Oh, okay.
And that's why he stole the original copy of the manuscript and used it to create like monsters, but they needed virginal blood and that he didn't have it. And that's why Dracula, when he created it from the book, was like, I don't know, like 3 foot tall, dwarf. Yeah. And Dracula, at that point, comes back out. I'm like, Dracula, he's still pissed off.
Oh, okay.
So that's why he was mad. That's why that movie just is
That's awful. Why he grew up to be Jersey Shore Dracula.
That's why he became Jersey Shore Dracula. It was awful. Three-foot Dracula is on par with the Jersey Shore Dracula.
Oh, but not one, even close. 1 can be Jersey Shore Dracula.
No, I think like a little person Dracula... Like Joe Pesci Dracula. That's almost Jersey Shore.
Joe Pesci. Yeah.
It's almost Dracula. Mean. Yeah. But that size Dracula, yeah. Mad about being small, trying to build an army, and they're all just dwarves and little people. Horrible.
That was called The Creeps. But anyways, like Train to Busan, like what do you give it?
Out of 10, I'd give that solid, like, that's a 7.
7 Chainsaw Reds.
Yeah, lost some for subtitling, but that's not their fault. It's Korean.
Gene?
All right.
What do you give? What do you rate The Train to Busan?
Never seen.
1 to 10. That's a movie we just watched.
Oh, yeah. I'd give it a 4.
Out of 10. 4 is terrible. 10?
1 out of 10.
1 out of 10. I'd give it 6.
All right.
That's not bad. It's pretty good. Elena?
I give it 6. 6? Yeah.
What'd you say?
I went with 7. I like it. Yeah.
I gave it an 8 decent. Just because it makes me want to cry.
I mean, the one thing about those, those types of zombie movies, it's like...
It's seriously sad.
Well, it's like Dawn of the Dead. You know, when they're all stuck in the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're stuck on the train while everything else around them is going to hell.
But here's the funny thing is that those movies I can watch and not feel a goddamn thing. I watch this movie, I want to grab a
T-shirt. Well, it's not getting so...
I don't know, man.
They're so style movies.
They're just so formulaic when it comes to your emotions.
I mean,
formulaic.
Whatever.
Americans are doing it wrong, though.
There's something, yeah, there's definitely something more emotional when the South Koreans get a hold of a movie and do it, spin it. Because even their, like, I don't know, even their deaths of characters are just a little more deeper for some reason. It's like, oh, wow. Yeah. It's like, did he need to be killed that way? Yeah. No, but we're South Korean, we're going to do it.
We're going to do it anyway.
They build characters really well.
Yeah, make you kind of feel for the characters.
Yeah, they know how to get into detail, like, real well. So.
It's like, felt bad for the stewardess that got bit first. Like, really? Damn, that's sad. That's quick.
Well,
she didn't have that coming.
It's like the way they get people to, like, you know, give their lives. Like, it's like, you know, people in the other movies and American versions, like, they sacrifice themselves. It's because, you know, they were assholes up to that point, but then they sacrifice themselves, and then you don't really care. Nobody cares. These people, like, were nice people that were giving their lives, and I don't know. It was just different.
You felt like kind of, like, almost bond with them because they were just like, that's not just a nice person.
Yeah, it's like, well, fuck, maybe we could all be that nice one day.
The old sisters, just like, damn.
It just makes me think of how, like, you know, shitty we are sometimes.
We're
all nice when we want to be.
There's a lot of details that, yeah, you can personally take away from it.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I guess if it had to come down to it, you know, some of us would do the same thing for our own people that we love and care about. So.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So,
I agree.
Definitely good.
I wouldn't be happy about it. I'd be pretty fucking pissed. I'm still getting pissed.
Like,
it's like,
be like, God damn it, now I have to save your ass with my life? All right, motherfucker.
Like, you fuckers. I'm sitting here holding the damn train door. It's like, fuck. Should have taped my hand. Fucking.
Yeah. Hey, get out.
Yeah.
Should have taped my hand.
Son of a bitch. It's all right, man. It's all right. It's like, you know, I love you, but God damn you.
You're the reason I'm dead.
Yeah.
Damn it.
You better not die 10 minutes later.
That's exactly what's going to happen.
That's where it goes. That's all I'll be thinking in your mind.
So. But you ain't going to know about it anyway.
Yeah, that's true. I don't care no more if I'm dead.
Yep.
Anyway.
Do whatever.
Yeah. But, yeah.
Up to that point, I'm pretty pissed.
That's when you're saved.
Yeah. By the Holy Jesus. Spirit.
By the void.
By the void, the abyss.
Yep, there we go. That's a very Halloween.
It's one of those two.
All right, let's wrap this episode up. We got anything? Anybody got anything they want to say? Halloweenish stuff. I'm not sure if we're gonna have any time for next week's Halloween episode, or if we're gonna bother because it's Halloween. Most of us could just goof off.
Like a Halloween Eve, because that's like next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday, we could do a Halloween Eve.
Was this the end of it?
No, hell no. This is just like, we might take a week off for Halloween. That's a major Halloween.
It's just the beginning.
Yes.
Oh, say it. That was great. Good.
It's a one-off.
It's a one-off. It's like Chewbacca with
or
you.
Or one-off.
Well,
oh, damn it. There
it's
it
like,
is.
He's like, Chewbacca's a Bigfoot. You son of a bitch. You bastard.
Chewbacca's a Bigfoot. Star
Wars. Star Wars is good.
Well, all right, so, what you got to do, kids, is that you have to go through the cornfields. You go through the maze, and Clayton might find you.
I was gonna say you gotta reach to the bowels of your lungs.
It's like, oh, you son of a bitch! If I find you in my cornfield.
That's awful.
Yeah.
Cornfield.
So, yes.
Clayton will find you.
In the future, we may actually do a video. I keep saying video. We're not going to do a video. We're damn ugly as fuck. We're going to do like an audio. Maybe next year we might do an audio theater performance of Jersey Shore Dracula if we can get a script wrote.
Oh, God. I mean, no, it's about, we're eventually just going to have Jersey Shore Dracula join the show.
I think so. I think we definitely need him as a special guest.
Yeah.
The occasional, like, special guest.
You know, it's like, I came up with the concept, the slogan is like, it's like Dracula doesn't suck blood. Jersey Shore Dracula doesn't suck blood. He just sucks ass. Like, not literal ass. He just
following up the other night about.
I thought we were gonna go with. He can jam, but he can't tan.
He can't tan. He's the man with no tan.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's been taken.
Because Who takes that? Nobody's taking that.
Yeah, I mean,
I don't think vampires try to tan.
It could, yeah. But it's like, instead of sucking blood, it just sucks ass. Not even like real ass. It just sucks. And he's trying to be cool in Jersey Shore, you know?
Yes, maybe.
I'm here to jump on all the grenades, yeah.
Are you gonna jump on grenades, man?
Yeah, this was awful. Last episode, like, we'll post that later.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
We got the sound for the sound, and yeah, all right. Good lord. Oh, God, it was some grenades. There were grenades jumped on. These two were the grenades.
Oh, God.
Jumpers.
It was pretty bad. The concept of Jersey Shore Dracula came up
last week. I don't even have to jump on grenades. I'll put the pin back in, I'll take care of it.
Whoa.
That's he's daring.
Gino Antiguida.
That's why his last name is Brunelli, I guess.
Brunelli.
He put the pin back in the grenade.
Yeah. Dangerous. Well, I mean, you know, we're going to wear our costumes next week, which is our fucking ugly mugs. So.
Yeah.
I'll just bring myself.
I'm ugly.
All right. We're going to wrap this up and... I don't know, that's it. I've got some more I got to bring on, but we're going to wrap this up. This has been the Chainsaw Bar. I thank you all for listening. Happy Halloween if we don't hear you next week. If not...
God damn it.
This has been me.
Clayton.
Here, Bill.
Yep. Delano.
Yep. We all thank you for listening. Chainsaw Bar off.